Hello guys, welcome to the video. I hope you all are well. Okay guys, the update to the Immortal Mage Plaguebringer build, man. Okay guys, since the last video, I've made this build even tougher. Now it's even tougher and it has way, way more DPS, man. So here we go, man. He's back with that sexy transmog. I love this transmog. Okay guys, what is this build? Basically, it's an ailments build. Okay, so we've got loads and loads of spells that basically causes a lot of damage over time effects. Got loads of CC. And pretty much you can't die, okay? You're absolutely solid as hell, man. Loads and loads of health regen, high HP pool, and you generate a ton of this health per second. Right now I'm doing 4.7k HP per tick, which is huge. And we've got an enormous amount of all res as well, man. So we've got tons of resistances, and yeah, very, very, very tanky. And it's also very, very newbie prayer friendly. Okay, then, guys. So first thing first, let's go show the skill tree, just show how all this all works, yeah? Okay, so what you want to do, the guys, you want to run through here this way through first, through Scholar. You need to turn the wheel around, by the way, to match this up correctly, by the way. So make sure you do that. So yeah, when you first start off, guys, just go through this line here, which is Scholar. Okay, let's go through here first, pick this up here, Attrition Strategist. In the description of this video, guys, there will be a snack guide and the tree, so you can follow it exactly. So that way you don't have to keep going through the footage of the video. Okay, then what I did, I popped down to here and make sure you get Scholar Increase Awareness. This gives you 15 radius for picking up any globes in the game. Okay, it's pretty much the whole screen, which is fantastic. So as you're generating globes, toxic globes, especially in this build, you don't have to pick them up, they're just done for you instantaneously. It's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Then guys, work through here to the Cabalist Tree. Okay, Cabalist Tree here gives you loads and loads of ailment stacks, and this is how you start building up your DPS in this particular build. Okay. So you get tons of ailment snacks here, and the more ailment snacks you have on a target, the more DPS you would do. Okay, the enemy grants a 5% damage to a corresponding damage type for each ailment stack on that enemy at the 5% damage type. So it's a major tree. Just follow all this, these little dots here, guys, you can't go wrong. Nice. Then once you've done this tree here, pop up here and grab Grievous Afflictions. Now apply an extra one additional ailment on top as well, which is great. An extra ailment damage there as well. Right, so one of the main nodes, guys, in this build is this one right here on the Undertaker, Plaguebringer Undertaker. This is what gives you a lot of your DPS in this build. Enemies that die near you have a chance to drop a green globe. They've actually done, I think there's a typo there. Yeah, there's a typo there, guys. Look, G green. Wasn't team. Can you fix that, please? if you pick up this globe, guys, increases your toxic damage for a short duration. This buff snacks with each globe that is picked up. So basically, enemies that die in a 20-meter radius around you have a 10% chance to drop green globes, and it gives you a 30% damage increase as poison for 5 seconds, which is huge. And also, there's a toxic damage here and here as well. Fantastic. So yeah, your bread and butter is this spell here, Plague Burst. Okay, as mobs die in this AoE, they will explode and do little poison clouds, and it ticks up and up and up because you're killing so many mobs, you're jacking your poison damage up. So as you're killing enemies, go to show details, scroll down to your poison here under status ailments, and watch this number here just go through the roof. Go through the roof, man. It's crazy. It's nice. So let's go back. So yeah guys, basically this tree here generates globes for you and empowers your toxic damage and makes Plaguebringer, man, just go through the roof. Okay, once you've done this tree here, guys, come down here into this tree here, the Siegebreaker tree. This is where all your toughness comes from, okay? Notably this one here, Siegebreaker, Salvatory Anchor, okay? So if we read this out quickly, if you have a Bruiser chest plate, you receive a health regeneration for every health point on that armor, okay? So you can see here, I've got a very nice chest plate here. It's not that great, actually. I need to get a legendary one yet. But 3.4k HP, okay? So it's given me an absolutely insane amount of health regen, right? See there, 4.6. Take this off, I need 1.6. So you can see, man, make sure you get one with increased maximum health on this item. And it goes through the roof. It's so, so cool, man. And this will help you stay alive for a long, long time. Then you go off this little tree here, guys, and it's the same thing again. But this time it's for the helmet. 0 point health regeneration for every health point equipped on the Bruiser helmet. Okay, so that's why we're wearing a Bruiser helmet. Exactly, once again, with HP in there. Well, this current one is actually doesn't have HP bonus. I'm actually getting less regen than I should, but this one had particularly good stats, so I used it. But I'm looking for a new one which has got the increased HP regen, so I can go even higher, man. Being right, I'm surviving absolutely fine. It's great. Then what you can do, guys, the next part of the node, just come down this way here and go to Siegebreaker, Disallowing Vessel, okay? You lose a lot of movement speed on this, but I put Teleport in this build so you're still mobile. But basically, you get 10 exonerable points, okay? And basically, it gives you a 60% damage buff, which is huge, okay? And you want to be standing still most of the time anyway, because you could just stand there in the middle of all these mobs, okay? And just drop all your AoE and everything's going to die around you. It's brilliant. And then this last one here, guys, Siegebreaker Secure Parry, 0.1 health regeneration per exonerable point. And then more importantly, 10% all resistance per exonerable point. So you get a huge all resistance buff as well. And it just works perfectly. Guys, for the rest of your armor, just go heavy. Just go heavy and try to get all resistance buffs on all your gear. Okay? I just need to replace a lot of mine. Like this one's kind of weak now. But the more all resistance you have, the more it's going to get buffed by that tree node. Okay? And as I said earlier, you can see the resistances. This keeps you alive for a long, long time, man. Look at this, like 9.8 right now. You know, I can improve this better. You can also put in those gems, guys, as well, which I've got in my legs here. They give you all resistance score. I can never remember what they're called. Is it Alexandrites? Yes, Alexandrites, guys. So you see that they're on defensive free, 16% to all resistance score. So what I've done, I sacrificed a little bit of health. I'm going to put health gems in my gear because I got so much. I thought, let's put in some all res because it's going to be a better effective hit points that way. Nice. Let's go back to health tree here again, guys. So, if you've done that, okay, I would definitely go over to this way next, okay? So work your way through here. And what I've done is you grab an extra bit of cooldown here, which is great. Go through to here, and basically right here, Soldier Second Wind. When under 30% maximum health, a trigger of a burst of health regeneration. This is your safeguard, okay? So somehow if a monster does get you down to 30%, you get a massive surge of HP regen that will keep you alive, okay? It's great. I'll tell you what, if they ever do hardcore on this game, this would be a great build for hardcore, man. It's going to be great. Now for this, guys, I worked my way through this tree here, over to the Time Weaver tree here. This thing is great. It has been rebalanced now, but it's still definitely worth doing. So I went all the way over to here, and I progressed over there to get the Aether damage, and got this here, guys, in which time cannot heal. This thing's awesome. When you hit enemies afflicted with stasis, we have a stasis spell in this setup, they take 100% of the hit damage again after a 1.5 delay. They use this rune here. Damage dealt after delay is increased by 20% as well, which is huge. Our stasis spell we're using is Anomaly, the pull-in spell. This thing actually hits really, really hard as well. Really, really hard, and we can cast it twice, which is great. It's so cool, man. So, like I said earlier, guys, I've now made this build even more tanky. So what I did, I went to this node here, Time Weaver, Dire Juncture. This thing is awesome. Your maximum health and force shield is decreased. Uh-oh, but listen to this. You only take 40% damage from an enemy's attack when they hit you, and the rest is dealt 1 second afterwards. Okay, so what this does, this stops burst DPS killing your character. And because we have so much regen in this build from this tree here, it makes it very, very, very hard for anything to take you down. Okay, so it's, and that with the burst regen there as well on top, you know, it only happens only one, you know, you only take 40% and the rest of the damage comes 1 second after. It's brilliant. It works so, so well. And guys, very, very key to this build is these two nodes right here. Impossible Soul for the maximum armor snacks. And this one also here as well. You want as much ailment stacks as you possibly can in this build. I'm currently on 30 at the moment, and it's increased my DPS a lot. Like a lot of damage, man. Like a lot of deep sweats. It's great. So yeah, guys. So then what I've been doing now is I've now gone over to this side here, which is the Assassin tree. So I popped up to here. I've now forgone this here because they've nerfed the crit damage from 100 to 60%. So what I've done now, I've gone back over to the right node here and got the material damage bonus, poison stack duration as well, which is great. Then poison alignment damage, guys, well, of course, for the big AoE. And then Blessing of the Jade Legion. 50% of damage is converted into toxic damage, which we are boosting through the globe generation from Undertaker. Brilliant. Then what you do, guys, go back up this way here to Assassin Clanstein Execution. 25% damage only with one enemy within seven yards. And take the node there to the right, an extra 5% damage on top as well. So it brings it up to 30%, which is really, really nice. If you want, you can take this node here as well if you've got enough levels for the -3 meters, so you can be right close to a mob and get that big damage. This helps basically killing those bosses off that have no adds whatsoever. Because remember, the more adds you have on this build, the faster you're going to kill targets, because you're going to produce toxin globes to kill that target much, much quicker. Once, guys, I finally get to top level, man, because I'm only 76 now, there is some other nodes that I want to get, like for instance, the Warmonger Bestial Frenzy. This thing's great as well. Like 4% damage for each nearby enemy within 4 meters. And you can buff it up by an extra 1% there. and increase the radius as well. So I'm definitely going to pick that up when I'm at a higher level. There's another node down here, guys, on Ranger. This one right here, Persistence Hunting. 25% damage to enemies with impaired movements from Stasis, Slow, Stun, or Frozen. We've got Stasis in this build, so I'm definitely going to pick this up as I'm going higher level as well, which is great, man. So I'm definitely going to pick that up. And there was another node down here. Now, this is the next one that I'm probably going to go to next. So right now, I'm expecting to hear what we're going to do now. I'm going to come down this line here and pop into right here. Exorcist. A Kamek Fieldwork. Basically, what this does, it gives you Headhunter points. Okay, so let's quickly read this out. Gain one headhunter point, a maximum of 5, every time an enemy that is a champion or above is killed, with points resetting after 30 seconds. Headhunter points grant 50% material damage. Is exactly what this build is. Material damage is basically poison, rend, and physical. Okay, so once we eventually get to this, the DPS will go through the roof, and I can't wait to get into it. So yeah, man, there's some nodes there, man, we can use as well. But like I said, man, once I finally get up to top level, man, and we can use these points to see what this can really do. But yeah, anyway, that is the plan, guys. That is the plan, man. Right, let's quickly go over the skills, then we'll show this in action. Okay, guys, so Plague Burst, man. Love this spell. There it is, out that big AoE. Okay, so I'm using a Swarm of Corpsicles. Increased area effect. Extra alignment damage, which is key. Obviously, you want as much alignment damage as possible. Got alignment score there as well. Average damage increase. Increases the chance to inflict ailments on enemies for allies inside the explosion area effect as well. Lovely. Critical hit damage, guys, 25%. Lovely. These are the main two runes here, man. Leaves a poisonous cloud when an enemy or a friendly summon dies, dealing damage over time. You just get these massive toxic clouds, and everything gets absolutely ripped, man. And then Visitation, increase the explosion damage for each ailment stack a monster has. We have 30 stacks on this current setup at this level, so they explode as well. And you just get a massive chain of explosions and poison toxins going off. Everything just dies. It's very, very fun. Okay, guys, even though Bulwark has now been fixed, it is still worth using. Sacred Gowns for the damage. Cooldown reduction here. Skill duration of 3 seconds, which is great. This one here makes it so it follows you as you cast it, which is great. Grants a buff to all resistance while inside this area of effect, and increases the chance of its ailments on enemies while inside the area effect as well. Yeah, the all resistance buff is really, really nice, actually. We can quite show that now. Here's my current resistance, cast Bulwark. And boom, 10k, 8.3, 8.8. That's nice. You know, and it just keeps you alive, and it follows you as well. You know, if we recast it, it's going to follow us as well, keep us alive. Very, very nice, man. Okay, guys, I know it's weird, but I'm actually using a pet. I know the game has been patched for pets now, and they're not really that viable even still with the patch, but we're still using the Liver Mortis. Why? Mostly because of this rune right here, Generational Grief. A portion of the damage received by you is transmuted to the summon. Roughly, I believe this is around about a 20% damage reduction. Now, you can run without this, but there will be a chance that you will be knocked down or killed or whatever. Okay, but just to make sure, if you keep this in here, it makes it so newbie player-friendly, guys, man. And when you're doing these really high expeditions, you know, it really does keep you alive. Really, really alive, man. I've already got up to, with this particular build and my level, I'm up to Paragon 139 so far. You know, so far, man, so... That golem really, really keeps you alive, man. And he also does some DOTs as well with these runes, man. This rune here, which is nice. Basically just made him have as much threat as possible in HP, which is easy, man. Nice. Okay, guys, so this spell here is completely up to you. I do suggest you use a teleport, because we're not that mobile in this build because of the incredible points that debuff our movement speed. So you can see we're kind of slow. So most of the time I'm just like rolling around, but that's why I put this teleport here, so I can just go boom, boom, boom. Just zap around the screen, pop a potion. And boom. To be honest, I should really drop my health potion and just put in another willpower potion, because, you know, we've got so much health regen. I never hardly ever use the thing, so, you know. But yeah, you can also use, guys, the other teleport as well, whereas Lightbringer. Lightbringer's pretty cool. I've not leveled it up enough yet. It's only level 42, but Lightbringer's pretty cool as well. It's another teleport. But yeah, there's a free open room there, guys. Choose what you fancy, man. Now, I was using Airfield Beam on this for the single target, but I found that most of the time it was interrupting my rotation too much. As good as that Aether Beam is on the Toxic Rune, you know, it's great. It's very, very good. It does a lot of good single target deeps. But what I did, I actually went back to my original spell, which is the Tear of Ethereal. The reason why I'm using this, because Stalactite Rain on Fire, on the Fire Rune, is amazing. It does so much damage. It does so much damage, and you can. It's got a really short cooldown. It's got a lot of mana cost, but it's got a very, very short cooldown. And this is one of the most spells that you can spam the most, and it does an absolutely ton of damage. So, if I cast this now, well, boom. Well, it's only got a 3.1 second cooldown. Look, now I can cast it again, and you can just keep this up permanently. And it does element stacks, it does burn AoE, and it absolutely wrecks. Yeah, it's a really good spell, man. Really good spell. So you can just keep this up constantly. And it does tons of damage. Absolutely tons of damage. I love it, I absolutely love it. Okay, guys, last but not least, of course, is Anomaly. I absolutely love this spell. This thing is so cool. So this is your CC. This thing is what pulls all the mobs in. But also, because we're expecting the tree over here, well, I wish the time could not heal, it does some really good damage as well, man. Really good deeps as well. Really good deeps. It's quite over the runes then. So, increase the area effect when it's big as possible. Nice, man. Element damage, of course. An extra 2 seconds of duration. The skills vortex pulls in enemies multiple times. So, if they try to run out of the vortex, they just get yanked back in again and just set up all that AoE and just kill them. It's great. Skill allows the casting of 2 vortexes, man, which we just showed. And last one, you guys, increase the element damage to enemies inside that vortex. That's right, it buffs all your element DPS as well. It's brilliant, man. It's so nice. Right, guys, so I have a video of this build in action. It was a, what's it called, that run again? Basically, I fully empowered a Paragon 139, man, with all the modifiers and some of the special bosses. Okay, so let's show this in action. Here we go. Rotation, guys. Nice and easy, man. Nice and easy. All right, here we go then. Expedition time. Let's pop this open. Make sure your pet is up, guys, of course, as well, because you're in combat riding. So what I like to do is I like to run around and try to round up as many mobs as possible. Remember, your big Liver Mortis pet is going to be taunting pretty much most of the time, okay? Most of the time. So, guys, first thing you want to do is cast Anomaly. Anomaly will drag the mobs into one spot. And then cast your Plague Burst, set them up with a big AoE. See the poison clouds popping off already. Cast your Bulwark, that gives you that all resistance and healing. And also does still good damage even after the fix slash nerf we've received the other day. And then you just hit Tear of Ithiel and watch that fire AoE just rain down and just shred everything. Shred everything. You see these things are just melting so, so easily, man. Like I said, it's a very, very easy newbie build to play, man. So that's why I don't much like to run around. Yeah, like I said, because we're losing some movement speed from the anchor skill where we get a lot of the health regen. Oh, misclick there. We'd be teleporting around a lot of the screen a lot of the time. That's why I really like AF to jump, man, because we can just cast them multiple times. But yeah, you can that skill is up to you. You can have an extra DPS spell if you were there, if you want to, It's completely up to you. For gear stats, guys, you want to be having material damage, okay? You want to be having material damage on all the gear pieces you possibly can. Make sure you get cooldown as well. Cooldown is king in Wolfson, guys. Get as much cooldown as you possibly can so that way you can spam with your spells as much as possible. Nice. For my weapons, I've got toxics to spells at the moment. You can use poison percent as well. I'm not sure what's best right now, but maybe just do a bit of a mix. I think that's what I'm going to do. I must try a one-hand melee weapon and a catalyst at some point. I still haven't tried it, but at the moment I'm just using the staff. My staff has poison element damage, critical hit as well, and element chance on top as well. Gems, I'm currently using 1000 maximum health in the helm, 1000 maximum health in chest as well, and then 2 all resistance gems in the leg so far. The rest of my jewelry has toxin damage, and my last ring has willpower regeneration, so as I pass my staff attack, just get a quick burst of power. And you see, guys, that the HP bar just bounces up and down, and nothing can touch you. Nothing can really touch you that much. So far, this build has been an absolute fantastic fun to play, man. It's just been so easy, to be honest. It's been really easy, man. So if you guys are looking for a really easy build, man, they could just chill through. And also, it's a nice build to play in a group as well, because you are so tanky. If you've got players in your group that are glass cannon DPS, and they're dying a lot, I'll say, on a really hard run, you can just walk up to them and just resurrect them absolutely fine most of the time, man. Main thing is, though, on the last patch, guys, the golem can now die. The golem can actually die quite a bit now, so just make sure that your golem is up all the time. If you suddenly find out you are taking quite a bit of damage, you're like, oh, what's going on here? First thing you should do is hit that golem button and just make sure he is summoned. You can see him if he's on the map because of the green dot. Okay, but if he does drop, you will really, really notice that 20% damage reduction drop when he dies, because that damage reduction share is just fantastic. Right, we've got quite a strong yellow mob here, man. That big Roberto guy with inside machine guns on his arms. And this guy was tough, man. I think he's got the tough modifier. Yeah, he's got the tough modifier. And I was like, okay, this guy's taking quite long. I could just sit here and just take him down eventually. And I thought to myself, well, we're a toxin build. We might as well, and not enough mobs are coming in. So I was right, but basically we need to pull more mobs to this mob here to create toxin gloves. And what I'm doing right now, I'm just backing up. I know he's going to follow because he's still aggroed by my pet there as well. Here's a few mobs. So just what I'm doing right now is just round them up a little bit because we lose time. Just sitting there, single tail getting that guy. We can ramp up by a ton of toxin DPS. Right now, you can't actually see the toxin globes drop because we've got the scholar thing on the tree that gives us 15 pickup radius. You can't actually see the toxin globes drop most of the time, but they are being picked. They're being generated and picked up 24/7, man, all the time. There we go. Finally got a few mobs now. So what I'm doing, I'm dragging the mobs in with a anomaly on top of him. So as they die, they cause that poison AOE, and you see now he's dropping much, much faster. There we go. This guy was particularly tough, man. He had a lot of HP, this one, man. And pop, there he goes, finally. As you can see, he can't even touch us. He can't even touch us, man. It's crazy. Yeah, guys, for snap points, just dump it all into toughness, man. I was experimenting with wisdom, but I found I didn't need to do any more damage with wisdom than, say, just like pure toughness. So in this video, I've literally just put it all into toughness. And right now at level 76, I have, what, 98,000 HP, which is pretty good. And I can make it a lot better. I can actually break 100k if I get some better gear rolls. Right, here we go, guys. So we're on the main boss now, on this Paragon run here, fully upgraded with 5 mods and all that sort of stuff. Thankfully, we've got a mob generator. Did you see that mob generator, guys, just before we came in? It's going to help us kill this boss super quick. You see how much HP he's got? He's got some really crazy staff as well. He's got regeneration as well. Look, material shield as well. My main DPS is material. And look how fast he's dropping. Look at that. Oh my word. And he's dead. And he is dead, man. Because what was happening there was generating so many toxic globes. Because that mob generated there, that soul harboring, I think it's called, was generating so many mobs, man. We just ramped up and just destroyed him. So that's what I like to do. One of the main boss there, just pull as many mobs as I can to him and just destroy it. Destroy it. So much fun, man. There we go, guys. Top end there. S+. We did that in 5:40. Unfortunately, no reds there, which is kind of annoying. There's the current details there. More damage. Damage taken. Healing. Damage dealt. Higher sound, etc, etc. Nice. The Immortal Mage. Did I get any good loot set? Ah, no, nothing, man. The other day I had double unique drop there, guys. It was mad. Okay, it's a quick mouse over, guys, with my current gear. You know, it's not nowhere near perfect roll yet, but even in this off-rolled gear, you know, it's working really, really well. Really, really well. Nice. As I said, look, just everything's into toughness. All the other points are just from gear rolls. There's my current stats. There's my regen. Nice. There's my Aurez. Lovely Aurez, man. And there's that poison chance. Yeah, but watch that poison element chance, guys, once you're in combat, man. It will jump through the roof. It will jump through the roof, man. And there's just a quick mouse over all the runes that I was using. Yeah, guys, so like I said, man, in the description of this video, there will be a stat guide, okay? So all this information. Hope you guys enjoyed the vid, man. It's very, very fun. Very, very fun, man, to do this video, guys, once again, man. It was really, really good. I hope you guys enjoyed the update. And here we go. Yeah, all those lovely runes, man. Yeah, TF Ifril, man, was so good. Originally, I was using the Lionation Beast on Toxin. It was good, but as soon as I went back to TF Ifril of that fire AoE that you could literally just spam, man, that thing's strong. That's super, super strong. And there's my tree. But like I said, guys, in the description of this video, there'll be a link to that tree exactly, okay? Nice, there you go. And there you go, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Feel free to like and subscribe and share this video. Have fun, guys, with the Immortal Mage Plaguebringer. This thing is fun as hell. And like I said, very, very newbie friendly. And my God, it's great. It's great. Okay, guys, take care. Have fun, man. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Special shout out to those guys who've been on the channel for so, so many years, man. Thank you guys very much, and a special shout out to the Patreon supporters. Thank you guys so much for those Patreon subs. You've got no idea how much that helps out. Okay guys, see you next time. Take care, enjoy the build.